So what's going on guys, it's JM, it's Speedboxing. Make sure you subscribe to my channel before you click onto any of my videos. Also comment below in the comment section if you have any opinions on what I'm saying in any of my videos. Really helps me out if you guys could drop me a sub or two on my channel, it is appreciated. So, Eddie Hearn, the promoter of IBF and WBA heavyweight champion Anthony Joshua, says that he's looking to put Anthony Joshua back in the ring in October against the mandatory, probably Kubrat Pulev or Luis Ortiz. Anthony Joshua, I think, has to give up one of his belts on whoever he faces, on whatever mandatory he faces. So if he faces Pulev, he'll have to give up the WBA title, and if he fights Ortiz, he'll have to give up the IBF title. I see him fighting Pulev. I see that being an easier fight for Anthony Joshua, and it's less dangerous. Kubrat Pulev is not really a big puncher. He's more of a boxer. He can pop a little bit, but he's not the biggest puncher in the heavyweight division, and I can just see Anthony Joshua stopping Pulev within 5 or 6 rounds, similar to what Vladimir Klitschko did in 2014. I don't see Anthony Joshua fighting Luis Ortiz, the boogeyman of the division. I think he'll be advised not to take that fight. I think Anthony Joshua would take the fight if he was the one making the decisions, but I don't think Eddie Hearn will put Anthony Joshua anywhere near Luis Ortiz, not yet anyway. And Eddie Hearn apparently is already mapping out Anthony Joshua's 2018. If he's successful in his next fight in October, they're looking to put him against Tyson Fury in 2018 in April. If Tyson Fury is ready by then, if he's shifted the weight and had a tune-up fight or something like that, then I see Tyson Fury being ready in April 2018. I don't see him being ready this year at all, because I think he still needs to do a lot of work to get down to fighting weight and just to get back into the moment and get back into the division. And I think that will be a massive fight in front of 90,000 people at Wembley yet again. And if Anthony Joshua manages to knock off Tyson Fury, which a lot of people are saying he won't do because Fury is a better technical boxer, he's bigger than Anthony Joshua, people saying Anthony Joshua will lose convincingly to Tyson Fury. You've got Joshua fans saying that Anthony Joshua will just stick it on him and knock him out, stuff like that. Then Eddie Hearn wants to put him in with Vladimir Klitschko in the fall in a rematch, because Klitschko is apparently wanting the rematch. But I don't see Klitschko being ready anytime soon. I think he'll need time to recover, maybe get his confidence back, because to say Klitschko was a champion for so long, he's a guy who's always lacked confidence. So I see him needing a bit of time out the ring to get his head clear. And if he does decide to have a rematch with Anthony Joshua and exercise that rematch clause, it'll be further down the line next year. So to quote Eddie Hearn here, he says, "There's nothing I or AJ would want more than to see Tyson back in the ring, but it won't be next. Tyson just won't be ready. Physically, he's not at the races, and he has a lot to resolve in terms of his doping hearing and getting his license back. As it stands, I think the best chance of a Fury fight is April 2018 at Wembley. That depends on a successful defence in October or November. Rest assured, if we can make it all happen, we will make it happen. I believe Vladimir is keen to do the rematch. If he is, then it's the sequel people would definitely want to see. I'm sure Vlad believes he nearly had AJ out of there, and I know that AJ wants to iron out some mistakes and do a better job next time." Anthony Joshua is a fighter who's riding a very high wave right now. People are queuing up to face Anthony Joshua in the heavyweight division because that's where the money is. But I see now that he's defeated Klitschko, Eddie Hearn might just pull the trigger on Anthony Joshua. He might hold him back a little bit. But I see Anthony Joshua being in big fights now. I don't see him fighting low level guys like he has been. Once he beat Klitschko, which he has done, then there's no going back in my opinion. And I think in Anthony Joshua's career, we're going to see some big fights and we're going to see some fights. But that's boxing nowadays. Not every fight can be a super fight. So comment below in the comment section. It's JM, it's Speedboxing.